I just missed it. I missed the closeness of an audience, of a live audience. So just as soon as I got out of the movie contracts, I started to do live performances again. There's so many places that I haven't been yet. I've never played New York here. I'd like to go to Europe. I'd like to go to Japan and all those places. I've never been out of this country except in the service. You know?
Outlasted every other entertainer from the 50s and, for that matter, the 60s as well.
I take vitamin E.
I was only kidding. I don't know. I just embarrassed myself, man. I don't know, dear. I enjoy the business. I like what I'm doing.
I hear from a lot of people in the press corps that you really are a shy, humble, wonderful human being. Would you agree with that?
Oh, I don't know what makes them think that. There's a gold belt and the...
Lord Almighty, I feel my temperature rising. Higher, higher, burning through to my soul.
People to work for me that handle the things of a personal nature, personal travel, wardrobe, details, you know, personal relations or public relations. I have to have people like that, and it's mostly people that I've known for years, and they know that they are representing me.
Well, they're all pretty well skilled in what they're doing. It's very important, the costume, the wardrobe has to be there, has to be in good shape. So there are people assigned to that. The security is all very well planned out in advance. And I have to have people with me for security. And to make sure that I get to the building on time and get inside. And a couple of guys that I met in the Army, I met Joe in the Army, I met Charlie in the Army. And they just stayed with me ever since 1960. Well, Sonny went to work for me probably 1961, 2 or 3. So Red was with me in those early days when I was first traveling around. A lot of times just the two of us, you know.
How's the stage out there?
It's a low stage, and the lights are low, so they're going to be damn near right in your eyes. You're going to have to be careful backing up now, because the orchestra is right behind you.
I've never gotten over what took on stage fright. I go through it every show. I'm pretty concerned. I'm pretty much thinking about the show. I never get completely comfortable with it. And I don't let the people with me get comfortable with it. And that I remind them that it's a new crowd out there. It's a new audience. And they haven't seen us before. So it's got to be like the first time we go on.
If Al comes up and I don't see him, we'll tell him to come back again.
Okay, fine, sure.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. You know about the stage and all that?
Yeah. How do I know about that?
I don't like to stay backstage too long. I've got to please the crowd. I mean, I've got to excite them, you know, or make them happy. I gear myself to doing that show, and somebody could walk up to me and say, "Hey, your head just exploded." I wouldn't hear it.
And I'm never gonna cease my wonder.
It's a good sound.
That's exciting. Just traveling around and going to the show.
Get off.
I think it's because we enjoy it, you know, and we constantly enjoy it, which means that we, you know, we do two shows a night for 5 weeks, but we never let it get old. Every song is like we do it for the first time, and that's one of the secrets, you know.
Well, like, it's not a planned thing. You don't do the songs, the same songs, the same sequence.
Not necessarily. Yeah, we can change them around, but even if we do the same songs, they're new, and the sound is you know, the feeling is there every time.
But it's a different feeling each time, right?
It's a good feeling. We never let it down.
Well, don't you know I'm hard on the press? Are these yours, honey?
Because there's a new audience out there. Plus, we enjoy what we're doing.
We can go on together. From your eyes. Let's go.
I'm headed, man. I mean, this summer just ruined me, boy. I tell you.
Cage with us, really. I mean, you really do from the stage. I've sung with a lot of people, but he has some way of keeping you interested and communicate, you know, between you and him. And,
I'm not going to tell you how.
You aren't going to tell us the secrets? Well, hell, we'll get out.
Things are going behind my back and things. No.
Thank you. Thank you for listening. Please release me, baby.
I can't stop loving you. I sort of made up my mind to live in memory of such a long, lonely time.
Alone. But we will, we'll keep it interested, or interesting somehow, you know.
Hope it's more
interesting. 5 weeks, man.
Oh, shut up. At the end of the 5 weeks, it was, you know, it went by like that. And it seemed like a day.
Well, see, like, I don't know. For instance, this evening, I know you were running just through everything just for us, for the cameras, what have you. Which would seem like if you did the reverse on us and said, well, guys, just walk around with your cameras like you normally do in the concert, it would be a drag to us because it would be hard for us to get up to that level. But what's hard for us to figure out is that you can turn it on here just like you do on the stage.
Well, you know what's interesting about music and about all the people here, they find new sounds, you know, and they do things differently themselves. So it's like a new experience every day. the guy on the guitar will find a new lick, or the guy on the piano will find something, or the voices will add something, you know. And I hear all this, and it inspires me. Yeah.
Because, like, we watch, like it. It's new for us. We're watching things like you and the lead guitarist kind of looking, the looks that go back and forth, and we're lining up shots. There's, like, really something going on, some sort of magic. You know, we know already the game that goes on with Charlie Hodges and the kidding, the back and forth, and that's part of it, too. So there's a kind of thing going on there. There's something going on there. I notice when your eye goes over to JD when the chorus comes in, you know, each one of them is like a little turn-on, you know. It's like a conversation. It goes on each one, but there's surprises.
It's like a feedback.
It's a back and forth, and you're turning each other on.
Well, that's what I mean. I mean, it never ceases. It goes on.
And that's what we're looking for in the film. That's what the film has to explore totally. It's that whole electricity, you know, that's just kind of circulating back and forth.
I hope you find it.
Hey, it's not. Well, I'm glad to tell you, we looked and it wasn't there.
Thanks.
So we're wrapping.
It was pretty well. I like the excitement and everything. It was, you know, I think I see people of all different ages and things out there, you know. And if I do something good, you know, they let me know. If I don't, they let me know that. Like, for a while, it was a theory that anything I did would sell and so forth. Well, I knew that was not true. It's according to the material. You got to have good material. So, whether it's a song, a script, or whatever, it's got to be good. Or it's just it's a give and take proposition in that they give me back the inspiration and. I work absolutely to them, whether it's 6 or 6,000, it doesn't really matter. It's just they bring it out of me, the inspiration, the ham. I can't hardly see them, you know. I can see them, but not in detail. I enjoy it. You know, people wonder how I do it night after night or something. I really like it. I'm perfect at home out there. I may lose 4 or 5 pounds a show easily.
You're a fantastic audience, and we love to sing for you. Thank you very much. Take it home.
Ever since I've been in this business.
Thank you and good night.
How was the sound in that building?
Very good. Very good.
Very, very good.
Sound like it was good.
It really did. Good show. There's your security guy. Here, take this off of it.
Man, can Hawaii get sticky?
It's a hot time in Florida.
Boy, it is.
Thank goodness. Rainy night in Georgia.